ballots, please.
Can I have another second, please? We have some signature people living inside of Chalkwood, I'd like to pass up to you guys. We just, for a couple of hours, went around and we got some signatures, we'd like them for you to look at them, please. They're your own citizens.
Okay, we open our regular meeting. I have a number of ballots, please. Okay, you have your amendments and your financials, you have any questions or corrections?
Make a motion to approve that presentation.
All in favor? Amendments in your budgets?
Mayor, I would like to add something if possible for the board, to consider. Put on the agenda, and you just. Say please, board. My understanding, last month, that it was ruled by the higher-ups that we, as a public body, can now begin opening our meetings with the word of prayer. I had previously made the motion, called the law to not allow us to do that, or even break the law, to go into a moment of silence. I would like to make the motion that we start our meeting, since it's referred to the law now. So getting out next board meeting, you want.
I've asked you for looking, reviewing the Supreme Court's decision and bringing that back before the council to re-examine that policy. We originally planned to do that tonight, but given what we were anticipating tonight being a long meeting, we decided we would postpone that discussion until next month. It doesn't have to be done that way, but I've not had sufficient time to review that decision. Feel like I'm in a position to advise you on. My preference would be to wait until we have a little more time to discuss that and discuss it in a meeting where we have more time to do that. That's for the board to decide.
Well, if you have time to review it, I don't want to do something that we shouldn't do. So I'll send my motion to those meetings. But I think we need to get it over and done as soon as possible.
I'll be glad to try to come prepared to talk to you all about that next meeting. Okay, you had your budgets presented to you, have your comfortable with it, we're looking to have a motion to adopt it.
I'll make the motion.
Okay, any discussions?
Yeah, I just wanted to just make one comment. Our 2013-14 budget, water, sewer, down all, general fund, water fund, sewer fund, last year was $1.79 million. This year, our budget is $1.795 million. So, at the cost of the way things have gone up, and the monies that's coming into the town where they're supposed to be coming from, we're able to pay our bills, we're able to put money into rainy day fund, that we owe a lot of this to Joy to guide us, because I'm by no means a CPA and dealing with the office. And I think she should be commended on how she controls our money. I say our money, I'm talking everybody in the taxpayer in Chalkwood. For a small town that offers what we offer, to do it on a smaller budget without a small staff like we do, I think they do a fantastic job, and I'll put them against any town, any this size, anywhere. So, I commend you, Joe, too.
Second.
All those in favor?
Aye.
Okay, Ron Butler, ladies.
Okay, thank you. Good evening, Mayor, Commissioner, my name's Brian Buck, the Ladies Commission. I do planning and zoning administration on behalf of the town of Chappaqua. The item on the agenda this evening is a proposed amendment to the zoning ordinance regarding jails, emergency operations centers, and related facilities. There is currently no language in the zoning ordinance regarding any of these, as you are aware. We are exploring options to amend the zoning ordinance to provide a mechanism for these in the L1 Light Industrial Zoning District. We have received an application from Beaufort County to requesting us amend the text of the zoning ordinance to allow the detention center, jail, emergency operations centers, and related facilities within the L1 Light Industrial Zoning District. Now, straight off the application that was submitted by Beaufort County, I'll just read this briefly. To facilitate the development of detention centers, jails, emergency operations centers, and related facilities within the L1 Light Industrial Zoning District of the town of Chappaqua, a text amendment to the current zoning ordinance is being proposed. The construction and operation of a jail, emergency operations center, and related facilities is consistent with the intensity and character, including typical structure design, aesthetics, and construction, ancillary facilities, and required infrastructure of other uses within the L1 Light Industrial Zoning District. Specifically, in the ordinance, item 45 of the permitted uses list public safety facilities such as fire and police stations and rescue squad. The proposed text amendment is in keeping with the uses as outlined in this item. The proposed text amendment would revise section 6.07, which is Light Industrial Zoning District, Part C, Conditional Uses Permitted, to add an item 3, Detention Centers, Jails, Emergency Operations Centers, and Related Facilities. As part of a conditional use approval for one or a combination of these, the following conditional use standards will be requirements of such approval. Okay, and those standards are as follows. Conditional use standards for detention centers, jails, emergency operations centers, and related correctional facilities. Item 1, setbacks. The principal structure shall be located a minimum of 100 feet from an adjacent residential use or zoning district. Okay, still under setbacks. Item B, no principal or accessory building shall exceed 40 feet in height within 100 feet of a residential use or zoning district. And then item C, accessory uses and security fencing attendant to the principal structure shall be 50 feet from an adjacent residential use or zoning district. Okay, those are the setbacks. Item 2, fencing materials such as barbed wire, razor wire, or electrical fences may not be used within 60 feet of an adjacent residential use or zoning district unless screened from view or otherwise approved by this board. Item 3, all lighting for the facility must be oriented so that lighting is directed away from all adjoining properties and into the property. Item 4, exercise yards and other outdoor activity areas shall be located internally on the site and screened from view from adjacent properties and public ways. Screening required. Item 5, vehicle storage. Except law enforcement, staff, and visitor vehicles, all vehicles associated with the use shall be stored in an enclosed or screened area. The vehicle storage area may be screened with vegetation, fences, a combination of fences and landscape material, or other means designed to effectively screen the stored vehicles from adjacent properties and the public way. Item 6, vehicles entering and/or leaving this facility shall not use sirens or emergency lights unless responding to an emergency. Okay, so those are the items that would be set in the ordinance under the conditional use criteria. Okay, so basically, we're amending the ordinance, the text of the ordinance, to allow an item C, an additional item, regarding detail center, detention centers, jails, emergency operating centers, and related facilities within the L1 zoning district. This item did go before the planning board. The planning board met on April the 21st. The item was heard and was sent to this board with an unfavorable recommendation. We discussed that at the call for public hearing at last month's meeting. Also, this item has been advertised per statutory requirements, the 2 weeks as outlined in the statutes. And an additional item that you have before you this evening that is included with this is a statement of consistency. You have that in your packet. Which is a requirement of General Statute 168.383. In any findings of a rezoning or zoning amendment, a statement of consistency must be endorsed prior to the adoption of the text amendment. And I'll be glad to answer any questions that you may have.
So this has got to be adopted before?
Endorsed, correct.
Endorsed.
Prior to the adoption of the text amendment for General Statute 168.383.
Okay. I'll make a motion to endorse it.
I'll second the motion. Okay. Any discussion?
If you would like, I would be glad to read the letter of consistency.
Yes,
so be it.
Yes.
That way the public and citizens have the opportunity to hear the statement of consistency. Okay, statement of consistency to amend the Town of Chocowanity zoning ordinance. Amendment to the zoning ordinance as defined in section 11.01 of the Chocowanity ordinance. The Town of Chocowanity Board of Commissioners approves the request for a text amendment in section 6.07 subsection C conditional uses regarding detention centers, jails, emergency operations centers, and related correctional facilities. The Town of Chocowanity Board of Commissioners met on Tuesday, June 3rd, 2014 at 7 p.m. and rendered a vote to approve a text amendment submitted by Beaufort County, North Carolina. The text amendment allows for detention centers, jails, emergency operations centers, and related correctional facilities as a conditional use in the L1 Light Industrial Zoning District. This use is consistent with other uses, such as public safety facilities that are currently permitted in this zoning district. In accordance with the provisions of North Carolina General Statute 168-383, the Town Board of Commissioners of the Town of Chocowanity find that the proposed amendment is consistent with the goals, objectives, policies, and future land use designation as defined within the Beaufort County, North Carolina Coastal Area Management Act Land Use Plan of 2006, the most recently adopted plan. Upon review of the request, it is the board's determination that the above mentioned request is reasonable and in the public interest of the Town of Chocowanity. Town of Commissioner action, June 3rd, 2014, and then there's a signatory block for the clerk to the board.
Okay. Anybody else have anything to ask Ron
second.
Okay, now do we have any discussion? discussions? Have any discussions?
All we do is we're not asking Beaufort County to put a jail out there. In fact, we're not even asking them to build a jail. I personally think we need a new jail, but what we're doing is to allow them to put it out there if they choose to on their own land. And that's why this come up.
Anybody else?
Yeah, I've got something to say here. This issue has not been taken lightly. I can't speak for the rest of the board, but I'll speak to me because I know what I'm going through in my mind and doing the job that I've been asked to do to sit up here in this chair. I've done the research and I have talked to John Nims. I've met with John Nims. I've met with the other dude people. I also met with McCallum down at Industrial Park. And they were just foaming at the mouth to see the land that we have out there for this industrial park. And the question of the jail was put out here, is it a deterrent? No, it's not a deterrent. Some shake your head yes, some shake your head no. I know we all don't agree on everything, but that's just the Democratic way. I've talked to a lot of people, and a lot of people feel like it's something that not only we need it 10 years ago. When I first came to Beaufort County in 1980, we were 20 years behind. It's 2014, and we're still 20 years behind. I'm not satisfied to be a Tier 1 county. To me, that's not speaking a whole lot for your county. Why won't it be known as the poorest county, or one of the poorest counties in the state? Would you want to locate your businesses here in the poorest county in the state? To me, that is a deterrent. Even though you get to borrow money at a little less interest cost. Which one would you rather have? Get out of the poor county and pay a little more interest? Better economy, better jobs, more jobs. Duke is doing this study. Not because Duke loves us. I've retired from Progress Energy, which is now owned by Duke. Retired after 33 years. Duke is going to help with industry out there for one reason. What do you think? To sell kilowatt hours and make money and keep your mind, whoever else has stock in the company. They will do no more, maybe have a larger range of what the state economics is going to do, what our own economic director is going to do, and Duke is going to help do. This is the third or the last piece of the pie to get this part where it's going to be sanctioned by the state. And when someone calls in and say, look, I want a place in East North Carolina, I need 40 acres, I need rail, I need natural gas, I need water, I need sewer, and of course some form of power. Everything that they need as far as energy is concerned and infrastructure is going to be located down here at this industrial site, which is a big plus. We have rail. There's a lot of them don't have rail. A lot cheaper to ship your merchandise or your industry, whatever you make, by rail. It is a fantastic piece of land. 20 acres is not going to force anybody out. Duke is not going out and say, well, Goodyear can locate here, we'll call them and that. They're not going to do that. They're going to be contacted by industries that wants to be located in East North Carolina. We've got one of the prime places right down here. We bring industry in. We're going to bring in more residential. We're going to bring in more commercial. And we're going to hopefully increase the size of Chocolate Wood. At more subdivision. Sewer capacity, we've got 300-some-thousand gallons. We are using currently 121,000. Where you get 240 and where we get all this from, which is another issue I'll address here shortly. We knew in 1994 when we put this system in, Chocolate Wood was going to grow. It had to grow. We had very little land available because it wouldn't perk. What now with the system in, it will perk. So, we've got a system we, as those own systems, pay for. Pay for it in rates. If we don't get it in rates, we have one other way or one other means to get it. That's raising ad valorem tax, which will only affect the 850 people that we have in Chocolate. So the more we get here, the better we're going to grow. And it's going to be a control group. But speaking, one of the letters that I received from the jail committee, it even went to the, under higher property taxes. It says, we fully recognize that whether to build a new jail or not is not a county decision, not a town of Chocolate decision, but whether to locate in Chocolate jurisdiction is a town of Chocolate decision, just as it would be true if someone wanted to locate a solar farm or even a massage parlor or a topless bar within an ETJ. So I guess now we want to have a safety complex but in the same category as a topless bar. It's just, as said before, a scare tactic. And some of the handouts is a scare tactic. This is one of them. I think it's great that people get out and get petitions and go house to house. But when you do that, give the correct information. Once you give the correct information, allow them to make up their mind. Not now do you want to sign this, or now do you believe this. It should be irrelevant to you. Once you give them the facts, let's make their own mind up. And in here, it says, there's a finite supply of available sewer treatment capacity. Yeah. There's a supply. And one day, Chocolate is going to be reaching what is close to their supply. We send around $250,000 to $300,000 a year over to Washington to buy capacity from Washington. If we need more capacity, then it's just a pass-through to the town. It's no charge to the taxpayers. It's only the charge to the developer. He pays for the capacity. It's just a flow-through. That's all that it is. We grow, we make money, county makes money, the city of Washington makes money. Very simple. Now to address the safety facility. Everybody calls it a jail. Well, in 45, already in our general provisions, under light industrial, it says public safety facilities such as, meaning an example, fire and police stations and rescue squads. Well, a police station, sheriff department, same thing. No difference. Police station in Washington or a fire police station over here, if they lock some money, where do they go? Where do they send them? I guess they send them to the Buffalo County Jail. That operate at the top?
Yes, sir.
So this is part of, and the reason why we've passed the consistency. It's consistent with what is already out there. The facilities, I've got the pictures purpose of being in the jail, I will admit, is to the magistrate's office. That's as far as I want to go. I don't want to see, you know, I don't even know what's in the rest of it. Have no need. I've seen the pictures, it comes right from it. I would not want my son, my daughter, my husband, or my wife working over there in such conditions. I do not, would not like that. The 911 call center has plastic on the walls. Now, if I'm wrong, you correct me, okay? Because you know more about it, Mr. Belcher. It has plastic on the walls, so when it rains, they pull the plastic down over the electronic equipment that costs thousands of dollars to keep them getting wet. Is that correct, sir?
That is correct.
Is that correct?
Correct, yes, sir.
It works there every day.
That is not true. Well, there we go. Yes or no? Okay.
Well, he's supposed to file a work order to get it fixed if it is, so somebody's lying. And I'll leave before I get in trouble.
The new magistrate's office. We'll have a new magistrate's office. We'll have a kitchen. Be able to supply their own food, not have to go out and buy. We're going to have the capability of housing our. They're not criminals. Not all of them are criminals. According to our democracy, and that you have to be proved you're innocent until you're proven guilty by a court of your peers. That 75% of them that's down there, granted, they wouldn't be there if they hadn't been caught. But until they're convicted, they're not criminals. They will not go outside. The chain link fence and all that on it is for only evacuation. Yeah, am I correct?
Yes, sir.
Will not go outside. Won't even notice there'll be a burn around. So I've done a lot of the homework on this. I think it's a good thing for Chalkwood. We will have coverage on this side of the river we've never had before. We will have visibility we've never had before. Which means a lot to me. And the tackle, we talk about a school. Okay? In the last 10, 12 years, we suck about $30 million in schools. We build them when we need to build them. There's no plans on the board for a Gray Road school. If there's another addition or whatever to the Gray Road school, they want to move it, it's not going to be moved out of the industrial park. It needs to go down and have a complex with the high school and basically have all of them located down there in one area. That way, my opinion, instead of having four buses going down the same street to go to different places, you will have one bus, go to one and drop them off. I would think that's the way it would happen. I don't know. Taxes. I've been told by Rand and also by Jim Christmas. Hopefully, there won't be any tax increase at all. I'll let you state yours and I'll state mine. I gave you the courtesy. I didn't laugh at what you were saying. Hopefully it won't be any. But if there is, you've got to give up something to get something. Let's get out of this 20 years that we can never catch up with anybody or don't even think about going ahead of anybody. But if it costs us a little more, it costs a little more. When the school comes up, we'll deal with the school as citizens when they come up. But it hasn't come up. It hasn't come. There's nothing on the drawing board. Move me. There's nothing on the drawing board. Is there anything on the drawing board?
It should be.
Is there anything on the drawing board? We should have a new jail or a new complex, but we don't. So it is both ways. But until it's on the drawing board, we will tackle it at the time. We have seen the people in Beaufort County, and just take after the hurricane, after the tornado, how they have band together. But thank goodness we had some outside people that come in here and really helped this county. If it hadn't been for the Methodist men, it hadn't been for the Baptist men, lot of places would still be in disarray. So, all I'm saying is, we've got to do some stuff for us. We need help. Four County, Tier 1 again. Didn't get any FEMA help. Don't understand that, but that's a different horse, a different dog, whatever. But I'm for the jail, I'm for the complex. Keep going to jail, for the complex is a detention center. I think it's something that's been needed years ago. If we'd done it years ago, we wouldn't be talking about $18 million. If we continue to wait, we wouldn't be talking about more than $18 million. I think the jail, or the center of the safety complex over here, is an addition to this side of the river and chalk wind.
Well, I'd just like to make a couple of comments. First of all, your opinions do matter. Believe me, they do. And all of us sitting up here on the board love this town. Most of us have been here all our life. We grew up here. And we put a lot of thought and research to make a decision. It's not snap decisions. And I know a lot of the decisions y'all probably don't agree with. But we're hoping that when we make these decisions, they're for the best. Hopefully that they are. So, but then the bottom line is, we have to make the decision that we feel like is going to be the best of all of us. Thank you.
Anybody else? Okay. Had a motion in a second. All those in favor?
Aye.
Yes, sir. We start off with, we put the flags up for Memorial Day. Left them up.
That's